kick early off the lead leg there from Parianto. Then off the back leg, Imoranji ties him up. High knee from Parianto. Aggressive start from both these men, Dragon.
A little dirty boxing from Bimawaji there early on. Parianto's got to be careful inside that clinch. This is what Bimawaji looking for. He's looking to get nice and tight in that takedown and get this to the ground.
Nice knee to the midsection there from Parianto. High knee there from Parianto. Well done from him. Single-handed clinch, double-handed now. Throws off the right hand down the center corridor.
Parianto's hurting him inside that clinch. Those were some gigantic knees landed inside that clinch.
3-2's combination thrown by the Unicorn Kings in all avail. Sprawls out here to Parianto. Back up to the feet is Imoranji. Pressed up with the circle.
Good takedown defense so far. Parianto dominant inside that clinch. He hurt him with the knees.
Oh, he hurt him well. First round finish there for the Zen War, and he made it look very easy. An aggressive start from Adi Parianto, never relented, and the knees folded in half, the Unicorn King.
Wow, Zen walk right through Parianto, or Bimawaji, sorry, hurt him with inside that clinch, landed some devastating knees, and just kept the pressure on, got him up against the circle wall, and then just unloaded. Bimawaji crumbled. Parianto jumped all over him. Impressive first round stoppage for Adi Parianto. Let's take a look at this action. This is where he was doing all of his work. Inside that clinch, goes right there to the body. You can see, shuts it down and then just starts kneeing him right inside the bottom position. Beautiful stoppage finish for Adi Parianto. Look at this again, just folds him in half. And then just goes right up top. The referee was forced to jump in and stop any more unnecessary damage. Go.
And Fernandez with the black and red bounds out of his corner. Outside leg kick there from Eko Grandona. Circling off to his right is Eko. Be careful. Drifting the power side of Fernandez. Fernandez just biding his time. Eko probing with the jab. Inside leg kick from Eko. Trying to catch him with that lead hook to Abro Fernandez. Skipping forward Fernandez. 18-2, three knockouts, three submissions. 76% finishing rate for Abro Fernandez. Being in great shape here too, Fernandez. He's treating him well thus far. The electrical knockout, 7-1, three knockouts, one submission. 57% finishing rate for the two-time national Muay Thai champion. Seven-time East Java amateur boxing champion. And one pride MMA bantamweight champion.
Quick little flurry as Fernandez closed that distance remarkably fast. You can see him touching Eko with that jab of his. Eko's got to be a little bit more careful when he closes that distance.
Both men still dipping their toes in the proverbial waters here in the opening round, seeing what each other has to offer.
And referee Mickey might want these guys to have a little bit faster pace. Right now they're just kind of circling off to each other's weak side, just sort of playing patty cake.
Thank you from Grandono. Who's going by the name Eko. Glorified kickboxing contest at the moment, this one. Neither man attempting to take the bout to the ground as we approach the halfway mark of the opening round, set for three. The one super app, one fantasy game, the world's largest martial arts fantasy game. Abro Fernandez had 58% of fans voting for him to win. Eko with 42. But to say though, so far tonight, fans have not been accurate as much. Sabas Michael was predicted over Taiki Naito, and Andy Housen was predicted by a landslide over Josh Turner. Both of them coming up with losses. We'll see referee Umeki step in here and ask these two athletes to pick up the pace. I believe we will in a moment. The filling out process has gone on for long enough. 150 remains in the first, and no real telling blows from either man yet. Posturing, a lot of feeling out, both with the jab. You see it there, no follow through after the jab from Abro Fernandez.
Distance yet. They haven't quite been able to establish their range. They're kind of just throwing air balls right now at each other.
Inside try and keep from Eko. Pitch sets circling away from each other's power sides. Jammed it from Fernandez again, no right hand behind it, no leg kick underneath. And Rafael Miki gives the familiar signal to get a move on. Tonight to be pumping crowd in Sky Beer. It's called a Siniano, very humid evening in Jakarta. In rainfall, just before the doors opened earlier on. Little fake there from Priyandono. Two men from two different regions in Indonesia. So tremendous rivalry between them here, Dragon.
Yeah, and they actually competed in the same organization here in Indonesia, so they know each other very well. So that's kind of what you're seeing. You're seeing two guys that are really just, they respect each other's power, they know what the other one's capable of, so they're just kind of feeling each other out still at this point. I like that low kick thrown by Eko. I'd like to see him put something with that. Start mixing in these combinations together. Start throwing the hands and then land the leg kick, because this is a really close round. One big shot could easily sway the judges in your favor.
And one of these two men go kleptomaniac and steal it with a big salvo in the final 5 seconds. Of course, three judges scoring this one as an overall. Just knocked down by a round. They go to the towels after one. Not a lot in it. Start of the year we've had so far in 2020, which will be the biggest year in planet championship history, already with sensational blockbuster events in Bangkok and Manila. And tonight will be no different. Five matches on our main card, including Leandro Ataides and Fenya Derida, the winner of which will get a guaranteed world middleweight title crack against the two-division champion, the great Onlan Sung. The Ataides will be the winner. Of course, our main event for the inaugural One Super Series Middleweight Muay Thai World title at Morikop Petunia Academy and Pongsuri PK Senchai Muay Thai Gym. Choosing for a takedown to Fernandez. First time we've seen one attempted in this contest. Went for a double leg high. And Eko, the electrical knockout, got out of the way.
Yeah, it was a half-hearted attempt by Fernandez. He didn't really commit to it. You could see he immediately shot back up and threw that left hook. I'd like to see him maybe going for the takedown again after that. Just start putting these attempts together to see if he can make some action kind of happen in this second round.
Mitch, is it just a coincidence that electrical knockout when shortened his EKO? Is it deliberately done? If it is, are you surprised there's not much more crackdown coming in? This one's been a qualified kickboxing slash Muay Thai contest.
You know, both of them come from striking backgrounds. We saw from Fernandez's past matchups, he prefers to keep things standing. So I'm not really surprised. I'm kind of surprised we're not seeing more action from these two, especially as we're entering, you know, essentially the seventh minute of this contest.
Some disappointment from members of the crowd here. If your referee will make you step in and give them another firm warning, Mitch.
Yeah, you know, usually we see, you know, our referees are a little bit more encouraging as far as the action goes, but now they're starting to exchange a little bit. You can see their distance is kind of shortening. Now they're really starting to exchange. You know, at this point, man, you can really put your heat on your opponent and really start taking advantage of this.
Halfway through the contest. Lead hand there from Eko. Gloves high from Abro Fernandez. It's a beautiful two-punch combination.
Good extension on his punches. Eko's got all the tools necessary. He's built like a brick house. I'd like to see him start really committing to some of these shots, throwing more than just two-punch combinations.
I was going to say, Fernandez is quick. Right? The size of the down towards the traps and Abra Fernandez. That should have been on post in front.
Yeah, Fernandez jumped immediately back into camp after the Augustine match. And so he had like, you know, 3 to 4 months really prepping for this match here tonight. So, and it shows in just his physique alone, not necessarily in the output, but in the physique.
Indonesia really looking for a star to break out amongst the ranks here at one championship match. And a lot of hope on Eko Roni Saputra later on our main card as he takes on Kongsichan of Cambodia. Also up next, you're going to see Sunoto, who's been around for a while. And hopefully, is he going to be the man who breaks out, become that breakout superstar that Indonesia is craving here at one championship?
Yeah, you know, we've had so many incredible Indonesian mixed martial artists, and they're just, you know, really starting to come to fruition. We're starting to see that mixed martial arts really develop here in Indonesia. And these are two of them. These are two guys that we really have high expectations for. I like this jab coming from Eko. He's got a lightning fast jab. He's got the distance, too. He's got that reach. He's got to start using it.
Crank down from Fernandez on the front foot here. Abro goes to the inside thigh kick. A little more flat foot of the two. Abro Fernandez. Eko Brindono up high on the board with his feet.
Yeah, Eko's just kind of a step ahead of him. He's just got a slight speed advantage. You can see the way that he kind of leans back when the counter shots come. He's able to stick that jab out there. Well, there's Fernandez landing one.
One though is not enough. Inside leg kick from Abro Fernandez. Needs some combination. Gets backed off with an overhand right from Eko Brindono. And the man they call the electrical knockout. It is a KO win here tonight. Final second of this second stanza. The old 3-2 there. Hit to right cross from Abro Fernandez. A bit more pepper now. A little bit more speed from Abro in the closing seconds. Good left hand to win the round from Eko. Go!
It's not that big of a lead. Fernandez could get right back in there, and he's coming off of a huge win. He needs to capitalize on that momentum.
Let's see if Electrical Knockout can plug into the power mains here in the third round and give us a knockout. We will have a knockout of the night award tonight. It's still up for grabs, though. I've got to say, Josh Tonner's KO of Andy Housen. It's going to be hard to top, but if someone can top it, it may be the man left at screen. Electrical Knockout, Eko Brindono. Oh, nice two-punch combination there from Abro. Looks for a takedown. Almost. Excited cheers from the fans to see them engage now as Fernandez looks for a takedown, but Eko a little too slick and evasive.
Beautiful Eko playing El Matador as he was able to avoid several takedowns on those attempts coming from Fernandez. I like that balance and just athleticism that Eko Parindal was able to showcase.
Okay, Drake lead half. Shoulder of the arms belongs to Abro Fernandez. Outside leg kick, Fernandez skips into the jab. Still more right hand for company on that one. Three, didn't go for the two.
Eko drops his hands when he throws that leg kick. Fernandez could just step in and throw that right there. He needs to throw that overhand right when Eko throws that soft leg kick.
But he's got to set it up, Mitch. He's telegraphing those big salvos at the moment. Take the jab, then throw the overhand right if you're Abro Fernandez. Not just the single shot, because Eko sees it coming.
Yeah, good point.
Jab again there from Abro Fernandez. A little bit down to the fold of Fernandez. Nothing too serious, though. Right hand lead there from Eko Brindono. He will put the foot down. Good jab from Eko. Throws the right cross. This match, you've got to feel, with 2 minutes 55 remaining, is still anyone for the taking. Who wants to dig deep into the well? Who wants to go hole for leather and really bring it home for the closing bell? Jab there again from Eko.
Fernandez is starting to touch Eko. He's, you know, you can see him putting that jab out there and also landing these little leg kicks. These are scoring in the judges' eyes. In a match like this where there's so little to kind of pick and choose from, those little touches count.
Another Indonesian coming up next. Sunoto takes on Yang Fei of China. of our lead card here from Estrada Senayan. Then in our main event of our lead card, Nyrene Crowley of New Zealand takes on Spiarata. That should be an absolute corker. It's all before our main card kicks off. Now just 1 hour away. Okay. 2 minutes remaining. Some better strikes on Abro Fernandez in this final round as he just edged himself ahead. Lands with a leg kick again to Zabro. And Dono, right hand lead, takes another inside leg kick for that femoral profunda. Makes the jab, does Eko. Inside leg kick from Eko Grandono. Left hook, counter left there from Abro Fernandez, came agonizingly close. Just shaved the upper lip of Eko Prendona. Now they'd love to see an Eko electrical knockout in the final 70 or so seconds here. It's a solid jab between the eyes, shakes it off, gives us a nice left hook. Overhand right. Now a little more engagement, the crowd trying to rally behind these two Indonesians.
Abro is a little bit more active here. He's starting to touch Eko with that jab, that low kick. It's always there. But he's got to commit a little bit more to it. I'd like to see him throw that inside leg kick and then come over the top with that big right hand that he's got. You can see the smiling. He's just in there enjoying himself. These guys are just playing touch. There's too much mutual respect.
30 seconds remains, third and final round. Folks, let us know on social media who you think is winning this one. On Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, and Instagram, @OneChampionship. Do you have it for Abro Fernandez? Do you have it for Mr. Electrical Knockout, Eko Grandono? Inside leg kick from Abro. On the one fantasy game of the one super up, the world's largest martial arts fantasy game. 58% kick Abro Fernandez, 42% for Eko Grandono. Last bit of flurries from both men. Good sportsmanship. Big smiles. Both believe they've got it in the bag. We will see in a few moments' time, Dragon.
Lots of sportsmanship shown between these two warriors. We got to see a little bit more coming from Abro Fernandez. He realized that he might have been behind right around that third round, and he started to apply that pressure. He started to land those big right hands, really started to close that distance. There's a jab that stuck Eko as he had him on his back foot, but he didn't follow up with it. You got to see that right there. Boom, touched him, and he came forward a little bit. That's when he tried the takedown, and we got to see Eko with some good takedown defense. And then nice little as the hooks right there as they trade, exchange shots. They try to close that distance, but back and forth action, I can see it going anyway.
Tom Lau is in the ring, and he's got our judges' decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have called this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner, Abro Fernandez.
Go! Iggy Rosten in the black trucks, Fajar, the macho one, in the white. Opening an orthodox stance. Regional boxing champion Rosten. Also has kickboxing and Muay Thai experience. Combat Sambo in favor of Pajar, who wants to get Rosden onto the ground. High finishing rates on both these two.
Pajar told me earlier this week that he doesn't feel like Rosden's got big threats in his hands, like that power really can't hurt him. So he's gonna be okay to stand with him, at least in these first couple of minutes before looking for that takedown.
Outside leg kick early from Macho Pajar. Open with the lead hand here, Macho. On the outside, throws the kick a little higher now. Shoots into a double leg sprawl out there from Iggy Rosten. Peppers a couple of right hands to the side of Macho's head. Good takedown from Macho, goes to side control against the rope.
Good sprawl initially from Iggy, but Fajar was able to lace up that leg, get that outside trip, and get Iggy Rosten to the mat. Now he's in side control. Eggy needs to take that knee, defend that knee on belly. That's the first thing he's got to do, but Fajar easily steps over Mount. This is a bad spot for Rosden to be in.
Exactly where Macho Fajar wants to be inside of 1.5 minutes of this opening round, set for three. You're watching the lead card of ONE Championship Warriors Code, live from Jakarta, Indonesia. Full mounting ground and pound now from Macho Fajar.
See, Eggy's trying to control the posture of Fajar. He's trying to avoid a lot of the ground and pound, but he's got to let go of the head and start pushing down on the legs to create that space so he can get his hips out. This is a bad spot to be in with 3 minutes left in the round. Eggy's got to explode. He's got to move.
Macho postures up momentarily, explodes on Eggy Rosden. Good crossing elbow to the forehead there. Downward right hand, smack bang on the nose. Another couple get in. What's Rosden going to do here, Dragon?
He's trying to go out the back door. You can see with his feet up, so he's trying to use that as leverage to sneak his way out. But Fajar's got heavy hips. All that combat sambo is coming in real handy. You can see those, how his hips are applied. He's able to kind of control the bucks and those hip bumps that Rosden's trying to do, and he's just riding him.
Fajar says the back door is locked. He's opened a cut now on Rosden with those elbows, with those hammer fists. It's all over. A brilliant performance from the Macho One, Fajar, pounding out Eggy Rosden inside the first round.
Yeah, it was a dominant performance from Fajar. He played around with him a little bit on the feet, got that takedown, chained up into the outside trip. Once he got that trip, it was academic. He was able to go from side mount to knee on belly to full mount. And then from that top position, he just started raining down those punches. Look at that beautiful outside trip right there. Ends up in side control, sits in the mount, and then just starts raining down those punches. You can see Rosden tried to turn away, and he opened himself up, and that had, you know, that had to have Kemp Chang jump in and stop the contest right there.
Go!
Elipitua Siregar in the green trunks, sporting the Kevin Ballignon-esque haircut here.
Oh, it's a powerful thing. Secret weapon.
Reaching jab from Siregar. Just a filling out process in the opening 30 seconds here. Eko Roni Saputra trying to press Siregar the outside of the circle. Good jab, no right hand for company though.
That right hand you spoke about is what his prediction is, to get a second round KO via overhand right. He's setting up beautifully with that jab though. Ooh, nice little right hand landed by Siregar too.
Good jab there from Eko Siregar. Jab from Rosden. The fans inside the Astura Sunnyan seem to be divided. What are the fans about in the fantasy episode for this one, Mitch?
59% say Siregar takes it.
Not an overwhelming percentage for Elipitua. Circles off counterclockwise. Nicely done. Gets away to the power side. Jab there from Rosden. Again, no right hand follow through. There's the right hand. And he sticks Siregar with it and forces him back. Every time he throws a left, he should be throwing the power laden right.
Siregar's looking a lot more comfortable on his feet than he has been in the past. There's that double leg, beautiful double leg. Timed by Siregar, but Eggy Rosden pops right back up to his feet. Might go for a ride here.
Siregar takes the back of Eggy Rosden. Get a try and sink in a choke in the opening round.
Oh, there's the rear naked choke. It looks like that house of cards is coming crumbling down.
Can he find the finish? Oh, he did well, Mitch. He did well. He's down the finish. Easy in the end. Some good hands early on from Eggy Rosden, and Elipitua Siregar got the back, sunk in the choke. Good night, Irene. Well done from Siregar.
Siregar, beautiful double leg takedown. He was he basically had Rosden thinking he was going to stand up and trade. You can see Rosden overcommits on the right hand. Siregar does a beautiful duck under, slides in for the double leg takedown. Lightning fast back take, sinks in the rear naked choke. House of Cards came tumbling down. Eggy Rosden marches his way into the winner's circle. Oh, sorry, Elipitua Siregar marches his way into the winner's circle. Beautifully done. Look at this. beautiful back take, slips that right arm right under the neck, sinks in the choke before he even had the hooks in, and then that squeeze just gets tighter and tighter. Rosden did what he could, but was forced to tap his way out.
The wrestler versus the Kumai champion, Eko Roni Saputra of Indonesia in the black. Hong Sejan of Cambodia in the black and yellow. And a chance drop early for Eko Roni Saputra. And he launches with a big right hand. And this is where the wrestler wants to be, on top of the opponent. Close guard from Hong Sejan.
Hong Sejan's got a good active guard, but for him to attempt a lot of crazy submissions.
Cracking elbow.
It's a whole different situation when you're getting smashed in the face.
Oh, picks him up. Hong Sejan drives a knee into the breadbasket. And down he goes. He's got the left arm of Hong Sejan. Mounts it beautifully down from Eko Roni Saputra. Is a house on fire. The Indonesian in the opening minutes.
He's got to be very careful here. He's got to try to keep it nice and close. He does not want to allow Eko Roni Saputra to posture up and start raining down punches. He's got to scramble. He's got to let go of the body and start pushing down on the legs so he can create some space. I don't think he's going to be able to escape just by hip bumping.
Big smashing elbow across the bridge of the nose. The chops come up for Indonesia. Indonesia does the hammer to strike. Saputra pulling out all the stops. And Hong Sejan, no answer.
Choice. He can just pick and choose his submission at this point. There's a nasty,
oh yes,
Americana right now going on in that left arm of Hong Sejan.
Oh yes!
He's got to pull the elbow a little bit down. He's a little too high up. The arm's got to, the elbow's got to come down towards Hong Sejan's body to really get that torque on the Americana.
Hong Sejan surviving. Eko Roni Saputra. Total domination so far. Sitting inside of half guard. Down strike, that's the right hand from Eko Roni Saputra. Goes on the far arm again, trying to tenderize and loosen up Hong Sejan. Fully mounted once more. And chance of Indonesia go up again and stepping inside the Astana Senayan in Jakarta.
There's an armbar on that right side if he chooses to take it. He looks like he's kind of just one track minded as far as going after that kimura lock. Or that Americana, sorry.
He's got the full mount again. And now the blows may rain down. The measured elbow, the timing, the precision, the power. Look at the full mount there from Eko Roni Saputra. Hong Sejan going to give his back. Here comes the choke. Here it comes now. Is this it? Is this the moment? Is this the finish? Squeeze it. Turn it. A hopeful nation watching. Can Saputra find the finish?
He might not feel it, so he chooses to go back into mount. He wasn't quite feeling the choke right there, so he stepped back into mount. Good tactical decision by Saputra to maintain that dominant position. Now he's going to try to posture up, rain down punches. You can see Hong Sejan's okay getting punched in the face. That comes from decades of King Kamai. He's okay to sit there and get smashed on because he's trying to reverse, but now he's giving up a bad spot as Eko Roni Saputra might be searching for a rear naked choke.
Hong Sejan, all guts and intestinal fortitude, and it could be over now. Is this it? Is this the beginning of the end? The crowd's at wild. It's the not freaking Irene. I can't hear myself thinking. This place has gone bananas. Eko Roni Saputra sends Jakarta into a meltdown.
That was a good performance by Eko Roni Saputra. Almost a flawless victory as he was able to get on top and then just pick and choose what kind of submission he wanted. You could see he went after submission, the Americana wasn't working, the arm triangle wasn't working. All right, let me punch you in the face until you give up your back and I can give you that rear naked choke, and that's the one that seals the deal. Big victory for Eko Roni Saputra here in Jakarta, Indonesia.
Hey guys. guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.